I'm Connor with Columbia Safety and Supply, and today we're going to talk about the Manual on Uniform Traffic Control Devices, or as it's better known, the MUTCD. The MUTCD is the written regulation on traffic signs, lights, and other traffic control devices. It is a national standard. However, most states supplement it with their own standards to meet specific needs. While the average person may think that the size, color, and shape of traffic control devices are simply to maximize visibility, most of them have a much more specific meaning. In this video, we're going to explain the MUTCD standard for some of the more common traffic control devices. First, let's take a look at barricades. Barricades are designed to communicate road closings, restricted areas, and delineate changes in road lanes. They must be self-standing, have a minimum rail length of 24 inches, and include at least one rail with alternating orange and white retroreflective tape. The number of reflective rails on a barricade determines which type it is, 1, 2, or 3. Type 1 are used for conventional roads and urban streets. They require one 8 to 12 inch reflective rail face on each side. Type 2 is intended for freeways and higher speed roadways where traffic is maintained through the work zone. These must have two retroreflective rails on each side. Type 3 barricades are specifically used for complete road closures and may extend across the entire road. These barriers must have three reflective panels on each side. If you pay close attention, the stripes on the panels will be pointing in a specific direction. This indicates the intended path around them in type 1 and type 2 situations. Next, we'll take a look at traffic cones. The purpose of traffic cones is to channelize traffic, divide traffic lanes, and delineate short-term maintenance or utility work. But not any old sports cone will work for this. They must be at least 18 inches tall and 28 inches tall on roadways where speeds exceed 45 miles an hour. They must also be crashworthy. Essentially, they'll either collapse or bounce away if struck by a car, causing minimal damage to the vehicle. The design of them must be predominantly orange and have some kind of weighted base or measure to keep them standing. At night, cones must be equipped with lighting devices or retroreflective bands. On those 28-inch cones, the retroreflective band must be 6 inches wide, no more than 4 inches from the top, and another 4-inch band 2 inches below that. Finally, we'll look at channelizing devices. These provide a smooth and gradual traffic flow through work areas and are usually used in conjunction with other traffic control devices, such as signs. These are predominantly orange and must be at least 42 inches tall for nighttime use. They must also be crashworthy. There are specific guidelines for delineator placement and spacing, depending on the type of road and the scope of work being performed. For more info on the MUTCD, we'll attach a link to the official manual in the description below. You can also find that on OSHA's website. And for all of your traffic control device needs, visit colsafety.com. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.